New York's Bravest by Mary Pope Osborne. Paintings by Steve Johnson and Lou Fancher. To the memory of 343 New York City firefighters who gave their lives to save others on September 11, 2001. Fire! Fire! Turn out! Turn out! The fire bell jangled. Come on, boys, said Mose. Mose was the most famous firefighter in New York City. Eight feet tall, Mose had hands as big as Virginia hams. His arms were so strong he could swim the Hudson River in two strokes. When others ran away from danger, Mose ran toward it. Now Mose and his boys rolled out the pumper and headed for the smoke billowing in the sky. They ran past horse stables and wooden shanties. They ran past newsboys crying, "Papers, one penny!" They ran past oystermen, roosters, and ragmen. Suddenly they came to a halt. A horse-drawn trolley was struck on the tracks, blocking their way. "I'll take care of it, boys," said Mose. He lifted the crowded car into the air. Then he set it down gently, and they raced on. When Mose got to the burning tenement, a woman rushed forward.
"Help!"
she screamed.
"My baby's in there!"
Mose climbed a ladder to the third floor. He hacked the wood with his axe and wedged his body inside. Moments later, he appeared, coughing and covered with soot.
"He's alone!"
the mother cried.
"Where's my baby?"
As Mose started down the ladder, it caught fire. But Mose leaped through the air and landed on his feet. Then he reached in his hat and pulled out a baby.
"Thank you! Thank you!"
the mother cried. "Just doing my duty, ma'am," said Mose. The mother baked Mose all the pies he could eat to show their thanks. Folks always gave Mose food and drink. Barrels of cider and coffee, bushels of oysters and potatoes, mountains of beans and eggs. Ragmen gave him their least ragged clothes. Shoeshine boys shined his boots. Everyone knew if they ever needed help, they could count on Mose. For years and years, Mose ran uptown and downtown, east and west, putting out fires in tenements, mansions, factories, and stores of New York City. One night, the fire bell rang. "Fire! Fire!" An eerie glow lit up the sky. Mose and his boys pulled out the pumper and raced to the piers. A fire in a hotel near the Hudson was roaring out of control. All night, Mose ran in and out of the building, rescuing bankers, bakers, shoemakers, dressmakers, preachers, and politicians. The hotel burned to ashes, but all the people inside were saved. As the sun came up, Moses' boys packed up to leave.
"Wait a minute," one said. "Where's Mose?"
The firefighters looked around. They all stared at the burned-out hotel. They grew silent.
"I know," one said finally. "He must have jumped in the river."
"Yeah, that's it,"
said another. He must have swam to New Jersey.
Yeah, I bet he's having himself a big plate of beans and eggs right about now.
Yeah, beans and eggs. We'll see Moe's tomorrow.
Yeah.
But no one ever saw Moe's again.
It wasn't long before the rumors started. Did you hear? Moe's is driving a mule team in the Dakotas.
Moe's is mining gold in California.
Moe's is working in Washington for President Lincoln. For a long time, folks speculated on Moe's whereabouts. Then one night at the firehouse over a game of checkers, an old-timer put the matter to rest.
You know what, he said, Moe's ain't any of them places. Truth is, Moe's is right here. He's marching with us in our parades. He's kicking up his heels at our fancy dances. He's skating by moonlight on the ice pond in the park. And whenever we climb our ladders toward a blazing sky, Moe's climbs with us.
Whenever we save folks, Moe's saves them too. You see, that firefighter, he'll never leave us. He's the very spirit
of New York's bravest. New York's bravest. The story of Moe's Humphreys by Mary Pope Osborne. Paintings by Steve Johnson and Lou Fancher. This is Brooklyn Blowback. We get naked with the truth. For children of all ages, Brooklyn Blowback, the world in a snowball.